Guys, it's Techno Viking 23, and I'm coming to you guys live today from the bathroom. And what we're actually going to be going over today is a quick video on how you can clean your gaming or work mouse pad. I'm sure a lot of you guys have the basic cloth mouse pad, whether it's just a black one or it's got a design on it or something. And just to give you an idea, I'm going to show you what mine looks like here. This is a Corsair gaming mouse pad that I have, and you can see there it's a pretty long one. I use this for a lot of my gaming and stuff, and you can see it is pretty filthy. I have a bad habit of eating at my desk a lot, so I randomly will spill things on it, barbecue sauce when I get chicken nuggets from from Wendy's, or just whatever, you know, if I'm eating the crumbs and stuff on it. So they just, it's naturally going to get dirty over the time, and even if you don't eat around your desk, it's always good to keep your stuff clean every so often. So what I'm going to go over is, I actually had no idea how to clean these things, and I spent a pretty good amount of money on this mouse pad and was afraid of ruining it, but still I kind of through trial and error have found a fairly easy way to get it clean. So what you're going to need here is just general kind of like dishwashing liquid soap. You can use shampoo or like a body wash. As long as there's no kind of chemicals in it that are going to discolor or break down the material, and it is a cloth mouse pad, so it's not too bad. I've actually found, don't use bleach, don't use multi-surface cleaner, or any of that other stuff, or you'll discolor your mouse pad and ruin it. And let's see, we got a cup here, looks like a skull, just disregard that, it's like a Halloween party glass, but just a cup to rinse it off with. And then we've got our silicone brush. We've got Miss Kitty here, who always likes to get in our videos and try to get all the attention. So she'll probably run like crazy when I turn on the bathtub. But in case you're wondering what all that noise was in the background, it is Miss Kitty. All right, and then finally, you will need a towel to dry off the mouse pad. I also recommend if you have a hanger, a plastic hanger with a little clips on it that you can hang clothes up, you hang pants up with, to get one of those. You can hang your mouse pad from it so it'll dry out faster, but I'll show you that at the end of the video. So let's get started. Alright guys, so we've got our bathtub going here now. It may be kind of hard to hear me over the water, so I'll try to speak up a little bit louder. But basically the first thing you want to do is you want to get your mouse pad nice and wet, get the water kind of all over it, let it kind of soak in a little bit, you know, however you want to do that. Just try to make sure you get the whole thing wet before you get your soap on there. Alright, so we're going to take our, we got our dishwashing liquid here, and we're going to kind of just put that all over the place, and that's all you're going to need there. So now what we're going to do, I've got my brush here. This is actually a dishwashing brush. You can buy these at Target or the grocery store, wherever you go. It's got silicone bristles on it, so they're pretty durable, but they're not going to scratch anything. So we're just going to take our brush, and we're going to basically just get in here and start scrubbing our mouse pad. Really pretty, pretty easy, pretty self-explanatory. So and just spend as much time on it as you think to get it clean. If there's problem areas or big stains or lots of dirty stuff on there, you may want to spend more time on that area. But you can see here, my mouse pad is pretty big, so this is going to take me just a bit. But you can see here, brush is working pretty good. It's not scratching the surface or anything. And you just want to, like I said, make sure you, a little bit difficult here with this big pad, but make sure you keep a lot of water on it. When you're scrubbing it, you just don't want it to be real be dry. Let that water soak in there. Let that soap get in there and get all that surface stains out of it. Alright, so that's pretty much it for scrubbing. That should be pretty good. Now if you rinse it off and then you notice that there's still stains in it, you can always do this again. So we're just going to fill up our our rinsing cup here and just get all that soap off. And you can see the water may look a little dirty. You know, if you haven't done this in a while, you're probably going to get a lot of surface dirt and some other stuff coming out of there. But we're going to just make sure we get all the soap off of here. So then finally I'm going to kind of squeeze, kind of roll this up a little bit and kind of squeeze anything else we can get out of it. I want to make sure we get all the soap. Get all the soap out of here. You can see there's still quite a bit of soap on this thing. So again, we're just going to keep rinsing it out. Alright, so we've got our mouse pad nice and clean. We got it all rinsed off. It's still pretty wet. So what you're going to want to do is after you get all the soap and everything rinsed off of it, you're going to take your towel and we're just going to pat it dry. Get most of the heavy water out of it. You will need to flip it over and dry off the back as well. Make sure you get that backing nice and dry. And then we're just going to actually find a place where you can hang this up and dry it. And that's why I suggested the hanger, which I'm going to show you here in a second. What I suggest to do it. You can also roll this up in a towel briefly to get some of the major water out, but it shouldn't be that wet, but pretty self-explanatory. You see here it looks a lot cleaner than it did when we put it in there. Some of those stains are gone and looks pretty good. So let me get this hung up here and then we'll show you guys what I'm talking about when I say to use the hanger to let it air dry. Alright guys, so we got our mouse pad dried off with a towel, the back and the front. Still pretty damp. It is going to take some time to air dry, but this is what I was suggesting. If you guys can see here, I just have a hanger. You would use these for you know, a pair of pants or some shorts. You get these at the department store. You may have a couple of them laying around. If you don't have something like this, you can just, you know, throw it over the railing on the shower or put it over the railing on your back porch if it's not raining outside, if it's a nice day and it's sun's out, it'll dry a little bit quicker. But you can see here, we just have it hung up. We're going to allow it to air dry and give it about an hour or so at least. You know, if you're really ambitious, you can use a hair dryer, dry it out a little faster, but this one, when it does air dry finally, you'll be able to use it again like new. And you can see there, it looks really clean, really nice and clean for us there. So there you have it, guys. And this is kind of an odd video, but I just figured that some of you guys out there might be wondering how you get these gaming mouse pads or just general your office mouse pads clean. And like I said, there wasn't really a whole lot about how to do it anywhere I looked, so I just kind of experimented myself on some smaller ones first to make sure I wouldn't ruin them, and then kind of found this way with the dishwashing soap, which seems to work pretty good and doesn't ruin your mouse pad. So there you go, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope it was informative. Hope you guys are having a great day, and I will see you again next time.